industry between manufacturers, and I think something that Nissan should be proud of with this is you'll hear journalists time and time again say, oh, you don't need the variable compression engine, don't bother with that, the base one's just great. And I think that's when they spend time with this base one, it actually is a very compelling powertrain offering, and has made it very difficult for the VC turbo engine to seem all that impressive. Pulling away on the motor's torque, the engine's at about 1500 RPM. It spends most of its time in normal driving between the 1300 RPM and say 2100 RPM mark, which is actually a great thing, because not only for efficiency's sake, but also for NVH, you don't hear much from this motor. It just sort of putters along in the background in a way that I associate with kind of the low revving sixes and eights that came out of the domestic manufacturers back in the, you know, before the year 2000, well before the year 2000. The cars that we kind of grew up with, hearing them kind of put by, you know. But the nice thing about this transmission as well is when you do get into the gas with it, it sort of switches its mentality and its mode, and it starts to behave like a conventional transmission. So I'll do that in a moment when I'm not following someone, and I'll do it at my first opportunity. But what that does is it gives you the ability to have a very relaxing kind of companion, jolt-free, shutter-free, largely noise-free. But then when you punch it, that was kind of a simulated second gear. It's a 2-3 shift right there. And it gives you that sort of duality in the car's nature that I find really attractive in this powertrain. I would happily live with this powertrain were it not strapped into a car I don't have any particular interest in spending a lifetime with. But really, again, downshift kind of, see how it kind of runs through its simulated gears, and that actually makes for a very satisfying experience when you're accelerating. Part of our sensory experience and satisfaction of acceleration is that gear change to gear change. And we'll see that here as we get onto a freeway ramp. Running through the gears, whether it's more efficient or not, whether it's faster or not, it is a satisfying sound and feeling and a satisfying association, and it gives kind of our ear and our mind. That just disproved me. It kind of hung like an old CVT. For the first time in 1,000 miles, I found kind of the balance point. 4,000, 4,500, 5,000, the shift. So I guess it, with real full throttle RPM, or full throttle use, it will do the optimal acceleration. I stand corrected. First time in 1,000 miles I've gone to near full throttle and had that kind of combination of speed and throttle that required it to do the old school CVT hang. But that's one time in nearly 1,000 miles of driving that I found that combination, so it's clearly not a regular thing as it used to be. And I'm trying to provoke this transmission to do the upshift strategy to be more like a ratioed strategy, just for illustration purposes. But as you can see, even just covering ground quickly, it's back to its way of thinking of keep the engine quiet, keep the efficiency high. I'm averaging almost 34 miles a gallon in this vehicle, despite the way, obviously, I don't as gently as some. So, really impressed with the powertrain, wanted to focus on the powertrain. I think it's kind of an unsung hero at the moment. You'll hear about Honda and Toyota duking it out. You don't hear a lot of mention of what Nissan's up to with powertrain, because really for so long they were doing nothing. And on paper, this really feels like same old, but in terms of the thinking behind this powertrain, it's been very satisfying to spend time with. Nissan, gotta say, people are sleeping on you, but impressive work here. I think you had to. You'd spent a long time soldiering on with old hardware and old thinking, but you took your time, and when you got around to it, you did the right way, so kudos there. Really satisfied with this powertrain. Can't say that enough. If you enjoy being along for the ride, let me know, and I will continue to do so. If you have some feedback on what you'd like to see instead, please let me know that as well. Let me know if you've driven this car and this powertrain combination and what you thought of it in real-world use, because frankly, I am enjoying this more than an Accord or anything in the Honda family, frankly, that's not attached to a manual transmission. So let me know what you think.